Good morning, I'm meteorologist Callie Zinandre. Well, once again today, the story will be the heat coming our way. The normal high for this time of year is 84 degrees. We'll be well above that today, topping out in the low 90s. Tomorrow, though, we see some relief from the heat coming our way, 84 degrees for a high. And then Thursday, back behind two cold fronts. Thursday will be the coolest day of the week. A little taste of fall coming our way. Temperatures in the 70s on Thursday before we start gradually warming back up into the weekend. Now, this ridge of high pressure, this has been dominating our weather pattern, keeping things hot and dry. Well, we're tracking the trough in the Pacific Northwest. This is going to move in, and this is going to suppress this ridge of high pressure and bring us some relief from the heat. We're also tracking two cold fronts. One will move through tomorrow morning, another one tomorrow night. That'll also bring us some cooler temperatures headed our way before we start warming back up into the weekend. On the future cast, getting you ready for today as you head out the door, along and north of I-70, we have the potential to see just a handful of showers and thunderstorms later this afternoon, but these are going to be few and far between. We'll stay dry here in the Front Range with clouds increasing late in the day. Then tomorrow, that's when that change comes our way. A cold front will move through in the morning. Also start to see some rain showers in northwest Colorado. That rain will make its way to the Front Range later tomorrow afternoon, stopping this at 2 o'clock. Through the evening hours, we could see several rounds of showers pass along the I-25 corridor. Overnight into Thursday morning, we could see rain showers linger as another cold front moves through Wednesday into Thursday, bringing some cooler temperatures our way, as well as a chance to see some mountain snow above 14,000 feet. We could see a little bit of dusting up there on the higher peaks and passes. Then those rain showers move out of the Front Range by Thursday night, and we're left behind with mostly clear skies. Before we get there, though, one more toasty day on tap. We'll see temperatures once again in the low 90s here in the Front Range, 80s and 90s across the Eastern Plains and Western Slope. And up in the high country, we're looking at 82 in Steamboat with 77 in Vail. Here in Denver, 93, 92 in Central Park with 92 in Aurora, south in Douglas County, 91 in Highlands Ranch, and we'll be in the upper 80s from Lone Tree through Stonecate and down through Franktown. Taking you to the Pinery right now, a neighborhood in Parker, 87 for a high today. It'll be mostly sunny with once again temperatures running above normal. Overnight, temperatures will be pleasant. It'll be partly cloudy, upper 50s, low 60s here in the Front Range, but it'll be refreshing up in the high country with overnight lows in the 40s. And then tomorrow we'll start seeing that relief from the heat right around where we should be for this time of year, topping out at 81 in Fort Collins in the mid 80s here in Denver. The super 7-day forecast tomorrow, those rain showers moving in here to the Front Range later in the afternoon. And we do have a marginal risk of severe weather up and down the I-25 corridor, also through northwest Colorado, northeast Colorado, where a handful of these storms could be strong to severe. We could see isolated large hail as well as damaging winds with gusts upwards of 60 miles per hour. On the super 7-day forecast, Thursday will be the coolest day this week. That little taste of fall coming our way with temperatures in the 70s, showers in the morning moving out by the afternoon, and then we gradually start warming back up through the weekend.